Hello everyone, welcome to Greg's Workshop again. We're having a bit of technical difficulties with my Galaxy phone. Keeps on cutting these videos out, but I think I solved the problem. So I'm starting to build the base for this bandsaw here to replace that little flimsy ass thing. There's the framework for it. I've got a welder two tips in here, cut some more frames and put them in. So I'm going to weld these two tips in and grind a bit today on the video, mark out a few more bits of steel. I might mark them out and pop them in as well while I make a little short video on it. It's the length of this is 900 long from end to end. This is the bottom. It's 650 from there to there, to the bottom, to the top, and 400 from there to the other side. So 400, yeah. And then I'm going to put a set of drawers in here, a set of shelves, two shelves in here and two in here. That's where I'm going to store stuff for underneath the bandsaw. So I'm going to have to put these on the stand. All right, so I don't know how this is going to work, because lately every time I put someone on the stand, and I zoom in a bit, they kind of cut out. I've got to go grab a piece of steel and I'll be back. Yep. I'm just going to grab this steel out of here. I've got the steel, put it down over there. Today's really bad. I've already cut these out the feet. Right over there. Oh, hell. Got a good press there for sale, if you just want one. That one there I made for that other guy. you go back and check a couple of videos, you'll find it. He doesn't want it now. After I spent 2 weeks on getting the order done, and now he doesn't want it. We can't afford to pay for it. In our old age. Steel in there in the weld. As soon as you hit there, it's pushing shit out from the airtight seal. Sideways. This is the door side where it matches. The post has got a, on the other side has to be this way for the door. If people are asking. Yeah, I'm kind of a little bit pissed off yesterday. Whole day out here. And I done 4 videos. I thought I had done 1. I'll try to get this in here. I'll then give it a tap. Hammer. Thank you. he's a fabricator, he makes panels for cars and shit. They call it something over in England, I can't remember the bloody name. Does a good job, he's a very talented man. I wish I was half as good. Things the way it made me feel better. You take it when you, these days, when they mask a car up, they put tape around the car first and line it up, and then they put the plastic over it and tape it down. I used to put the tape around the window frames and everything where I got a tape, and then put the paper with the sticky tape on it and follow that edge of tape. It was a lot better and a lot quicker. And I can ensure you don't let your shelf, another 400 here, which has to go long ways, one floor in here, but I don't think I've got that much steel. I'm going to measure it and check in a minute. Just died on 400. I don't have to work that out any closer than that. Then I'll have to go buy steel today. Is it 400? 65? Probably turn you around so you can have a look and I can do some cutting. Won't be close up, but it'll be close enough to so you can see it. Right. We can give it a move it in a little bit more. There we go. Got me buckets and tools sitting here. Push them out of the road. Put me coffee cup down. Perfect. Closer. Now I'm going to mark this and get it set up. From the inside. A little bit too far. That might be it, I think. 3:15. Well, it's 355 to the outside. Try and get this done today. Just I've got to go out at 2 o'clock, so, but it's 20 to 2 now, so in Australia. So what we'll do is I'll weld this one in, turn it over, put the other one in, and then I'll turn it up down this way, and we put the 400 in, and that should be it. Thank you.
coming out of that fucking... Yeah, it's a bit of oil coming out of the steel. Inside the steel, this has been sitting here for a long time. I give them a spray with oil every now and again to soak them up. Is done. I've got to go pay some bills. 365. Getting there. As soon as I weld these in, because I've got a buggy core and I ain't got the money to buy a core. Plus the welder's 20 years old and I want to put a new buy a new welder later on. done the new welder on CO2 on argon fuel mix. This welder will be continually run on argon fuel for all the heavy welding I'm doing. Then take me to her place. Well, I want to tell her. I'm just having a bit of deja vu, don't mind me. For this thing for a while. I have not seen one the same, so I couldn't take any measurements. So I saw one that was a bit the same length, it was a bit longer than mine, and content to it. Bed wells are right through. When I grind this all smooth, should be as tight as a bug's nut.